بسم الله الرحمن الرحيم الحمد لله رب العالمين الصلاة والسلام على أشرف الأنبياء والمرسلين وعلى آله وصحبه أجمعين الحمد لله وشكر الله وثانك الله سبحانه وتعالى for allowing us inshallah these blessed days that we are passing through in the last three months of those sacred months that the Prophet صلى الله عليه وسلم mentioned ذُلْ قَعْدَةِ ذُلْ حِجَّةِ and Muharram. So inshallah may Allah give us tawfiq to inshallah benefit to the maximum amount inshallah. So quickly today inshallah, as promised, I asked who wants to know about the impact of your emotions on your personal and business growth. And this is something that bothers all of us. It has bothered me significantly. It has impacted me on various levels. And again, subhanallah, we are not in charge of what happens to us in life. But what we are in charge of, which I'm slowly coming to realize, recognize and learn, is that we are in charge of our responses. And the better that we respond to the issues that you know we face, then the easier it becomes to actually navigate through you know the process of life. And what I find with a lot of my clients, you know, so because I see people on a very personal basis, that is personal issues, it's personal health issues, personal traumas, but understanding the impact of that trauma is very significant. Because ultimately what happens is that when there is a trauma, when it is affecting you personally at your own, you know, capacity and own level, not only does it affect you, but then just think about it. Where else does it affect you? It affects your immediate family, i.e. your spouse, your children, your parents, your loved ones, the people that, you know, you interact with on a day-to-day basis. It might even be your work colleagues. And from that, subhanAllah, a lot of people are also restricted in their personal self-confidence, in their personal issues. There's, you know, overthinking going on. A lot of you come forward and say that there's procrastination in place, okay? I am a professional procrastinator. I've been one, you know, for many years. I've got so much experience, alhamdulillah. Maybe I'll write a book about it one day, but just that I haven't got around to it. So inshallah, another time. So with that, what we need to understand is, where does procrastination come from? What is it that is jeopardizing your personal growth? What is it that is jeopardizing your business growth? And so ultimately, it is not luck. It is not the fact that, you know, there's so many competitors on the market. It's got nothing to do with that. You look at takeaway shops. Okay, certain streets you go down, all you see is takeaway selling the same thing. I'm usually baffled when we travel to Turkey that every shop, subhanAllah, is selling the same menu. Okay, and yet every shop has got its fair share of customers. Why? Because the rizq is from Allah. And ultimately what we need is, we need to present ourselves. And so it is your attitude, it is your mindset. Can you imagine those people in Turkey or those people who want to open up a takeaway or a restaurant on a busy street with other restaurants, if they thought, well, there's no point doing it because there's already a restaurant there. There's no point opening up a, you know, a Southern Fried Chicken because there's already Dixie's and there's already another four or five names, Pepe's and everything there. And they don't do it, subhanAllah. So in the same way, the mindset, if the mindset is clear, if your vision and focus is there to say, you know what, I can still make this work. I have to put in the graft. I have to put in the hours. And there will be goodness coming out. There will be, you know, an impact with regards to what it is that I'm doing. Then, alhamdulillah, it works. And so this is what we want to bring forward, inshallah, is for you to become aware, for you to recognize yourself. And what is it that's blocking you? What is it that's stopping you? Identify those traits. Identify the thoughts. And once you begin to identify the thoughts that are linked to your actions, you will be able to identify and see what exactly is blocking you. And for the most part, there's a lot of people that say things like, you know, I lack confidence. I don't think I can go out there. I can't, present my product. And there's so many people, subhanAllah, out there that have got amazing set of skills. Amazing set of skills. It's like me saying, you know, I've got, gold bars in my house that I'm giving away. But if people don't know about it, then how are they going to come? How are they going to come and take this away from me? They're not. I have to present myself. I have to put myself out there. And initially, it is going to be difficult. But again, the question is, what is stopping you from putting yourself out there? And in most cases, subhanAllah, it is the emotions. It is those lessons that we have ingrained in ourselves. It's the belief system that we've ingrained in ourselves to say, you know what, I don't think I can do this. Who put this belief system into your head? Who told you you are not good enough? Really, who told you you are not good enough? And 99% of the time, someone said it, but not in that context that you were not worthy. They said it to you in terms of your schoolwork or, you know, something that a task that you were supposed to do at home, and your parents told you off for that. This is not good enough. Or, go do it again. And if you start feeling, you know, put down by it, as children, we form our belief systems. As children, we form our belief system. We perceive things in the way that we want to because we feel either we are not safe and we are not secure, or we don't feel loved. And if any of those blockages start really, you know, clogging up the system, then this is what is going to give us this problem in moving forward. And so, how do we go about resolving this? The resolve, subhanAllah, is quite simple in theory, but it takes effort in changing. And especially if you find yourself now that you're, you know, in your late 20s, 30s or 40s, stroke 50s, the longer you've had this issue, okay, from about 7 years onwards or 10 years onwards up to now, then you need to understand and be patient with the fact that your emotional belief system is implanted very strongly in your thought process. And so to undo that will also take time. But subhanAllah, this is what I've been doing with a group. I think for those of you that followed me last month, I put out a video to say that I'm starting the Afia Coaching Experience, the ACE program. And alhamdulillah, I limited it to 20 people, but still it was oversubscribed. And we've started, alhamdulillah, the month of June is almost going to come to an end next week. We've had an amazing 4 weeks in just understanding the thought patterns. Okay, what are the thought patterns that are going on in your head that are jeopardizing you on a day-to-day basis? What are those negative thought patterns, and how do you stop them? How do you stop that negative self-talk all the time going on in your head? And alhamdulillah, there's been some amazing realizations with our group. And inshallah, my intention, because the first 4 weeks has gone so amazingly well, I'm extending this now by another 4 weeks and another 4 weeks. So inshallah, this is going to become a 12-week program, and all of it inshallah will be uploaded so people can come, simply click and off they go. So the first 4 weeks has been understanding who you are and what your thought processes are. The second one was to understand and how to challenge your own thought processes. Because ultimately what it is people get involved completely, okay, with their mind, with their body, and they manifest with anxiety what is going on with regards to their beliefs. So the belief of I'm not good enough manifests all over, not just your personal life, in your relationships, in your ability to you know, carry out your responsibilities, and especially in your businesses, because people that want to go out there and set up a business, you have to be prepared mentally that if that business fails initially, what are you going to do? Are you going to allow that negative self-talk to go back and say, I told you so, I told you so, I told you so? No, you don't. I have, you know, inshallah, one day I will be sharing my business history, okay, of what I have done and what it has taken for me to be here sitting, talking to you and advising you about this matter. Okay, and subhanAllah, failure after failure after failure after failure. And alhamdulillah for that Allah has allowed me to bring about what we have today in front of you, known as Afia Healing. Okay, people look at me now and they say, mashallah, you're doing really well. Mashallah, you're doing really well. Yes, I am. Alhamdulillah, thank you very much. It's my 10-year overnight success. It took me 10 years to build this. It took me 10 years by Allah's help to be where I am today. But people will never see your journey. People will never appreciate what you went through. But people will be very quick to come and start trying to count your profits. But that's fine, okay? Look where I am. Look at the journey that we've been through. And this is what I'm sharing. This is what I'm pushing you with, inshallah. And so, the first 4 weeks has been all about mindset, about getting hold of your thoughts, connecting to your thoughts, identifying the underlying behavior traits that are there and the belief systems that are there. Inshallah, in the last week now of June, you know, for our group, we are going to be talking about the power of affirmations, how to change about your negative self-talk into positive. Then inshallah, in the month of July, this is what's coming up, inshallah, is looking at personal and self-development for yourself and for your business from a CBT perspective, an introduction to NLP, and also in life coaching. So anyone that inshallah is interested in expanding their awareness more with regards to these topics, and about how you grow yourself, not just from textbooks, but from an Islamic understanding. Okay, how do we extrapolate the teachings of our deen in our self-development? And then inshallah, in the month of August, we are going to be specifically focusing on how to build your business. So inshallah, it's a 12-week program. And in that, inshallah, you get the support step by step of how to go from where you are in your little cocoon, in your little cage, to actually come out there to be able to spread your wings. And yes, there will be challenges. Yes, there will be problems. Yes, people will, put you down. They'll judge you. They'll call you names. Yes, there's going to be competition. Yes, you still are at the beginning of your journey. And so, how much experience do you have in the field? But that's all fine. As long as your mindset is good, everything else will slot into place. Even things like your understanding and your relationship with money. Okay, that comes up a lot as well. And that is something also that we need to address. Where does it come from? Where is it connected to you in your childhood? What was that negative association that you had with regards to money? And once you identify that relationship can change also. That relationship can change also. And so this is what we want, inshallah. Let's build you up. Let's move you up. And if you are interested in the ACE program, then inshallah, we're starting to take on people from the first Tuesday in July for a 4-week program. And then you can carry on into August, and then also get the access to all the recordings of what we have covered in June regarding mindset. So inshallah, if you have any questions, then please get in touch. I'll be happy to answer, as I always do. Please share the video. Anyone that might be interested, then please get in touch, inshallah. If you want a clarity call, drop me a message, inshallah. We can have a quick chat and we'll take it from there. Jazakumullah khair. Subhanakallahumma bihamdik. Nashhadu an la ilaha illa anta nastaghfiruka wa natubu ilayk. Wa sallallahu ala sayyidina Muhammad wa ala alihi wa sahbihi wa sallam. Assalamu alaikum.